Today we will talk about transforming the five corruptions, and the Amitabha Sutra, Shakyamuni Buddha calls our world the world of five corruptions. We will learn how to transform the world of five corruptions into purities, essentially by having faith, vow, and recitation of Amitabha Buddha's name. We can transform our current world right now into a pure land, and after death, we can be reborn in Amitabha's Western Pure Land. Now let's talk about the five corruptions and their transformation. Number one, corruption of age. This is a time when war, natural disaster, and disease are prevalent. After experiencing the coronavirus last year, we all feel the corruption of age. This is due to our collective karmic burden. As we know, the physical world is created by the karmic seeds in our Alaya consciousness. So our negative karmic seeds ripen into a corrupted world. Our positive karmic seeds ripen into a purified world. Thus, when we chant the name Amitabha, we are transforming the corruption of age into assembly of purity. This assembly of purity means all the sentient beings that are already in the pure land. The moment we recite the Buddha's name, we are assembly member already. And the key of chanting, according to the great strength Bodhisattva in the Shogami Sutra, it says to gather in all six organs through continuous pure mindfulness. Gather in our six sense organs instead of seeking out for outside stimulants. Have it come in, focus on the name, and continuous chanting is pure mindfulness. Thus, we are creating positive karmic energy that will be creating a purified world. And in the end, we will be reborn in Amitabha's pure land. Number two is the corruption of views. We have five corruptions of views. Number one, view of our body. We think this body is extremely important, so we eat good food, wear good clothes, live in a good place. But we don't know that this body is made out of temporary conditions. It's made out of earth, water, fire, and wind. Earth is our bones, water, our blood, fire, our temperature, and wind, our breathing. All these are temporary elements. They're conditions, so we cannot rely on them. Number two is one-sided view. A lot of people think that life is annihilated after death. Other people think that life goes on forever. Both of these views are one-sided and they're erroneous. Number three is a view of prohibitions, wrong precepts. Some people, they practice unbeneficial ascetic practices such as sleeping on nail or standing on one leg. And some people are superstitious. They think, oh, I must wear red because that's good luck. All these are wrong precepts. That's not the cause of enlightenment, but we think it's the cause. Number four is view of views. So we are attached to views. They are not the effect, but we think they are the effect. For example, we have samadhi or concentration. We think that's enlightenment. But concentration and enlightenment are two separate things. So you cannot say that people have deep concentration, they are already enlightened. And number five is deviant view. Deviant view basically do not believe in causation. Some people, they don't believe in cause and effect. That's why they do whatever they feel like doing. All these five corruption of view, all of us have it to a different degree. If we recite Amitabha Buddha's name, then we can transform the corruption of views into infinite light. Light means wisdom. So no more corruption of views and no more darkness. That's the meaning of the name Amitabha, which means infinite light. Number 12 of Amitabha's 48 vows, it says, provided I become a Buddha, if my light is limited in measurement so that it could not illuminate 100,000 nyota of kotis of Buddha countries, then may I not attain enlightenment. So if my light is limited, it cannot illuminate to many, many different Buddha countries, then I will not become enlightened. Buddha is already enlightened, so he is infinite light. The moment that we chant his name, we also become infinite light. There are two ways to chant Amitabha Buddha's name. We can chant on the level of phenomena. That means we see Buddha as an outside entity and we rely on him just like a child longing for its mother and never forgetting her for a moment. On another level is a level of inner truth. We know that Amitabha and his Pure Land are inherent features in the creation of our pure mind. It's not outside of us. You are the infinite light. Number three, corruption of afflictions. There are five basic afflictions: greed, anger, ignorance, arrogance, and doubt. Greed or selfishness, anger when we're complaining and bitter, ignorance, we think there's a self that's separated from others, arrogant, we think we're better than others, doubt when we don't believe in ourselves or the Buddha or Dharma. We have all these five afflictions. If we can recite Amitabha Buddha's name, we can transform the corruption of affliction into eternal still light. There are four different levels to Amitabha Buddha's Pure Land. One is the land where saints and ordinary beings dwell together. That's where we will go. Number two is the land of expedient liberation where our hearts live. Number three is the land of real reward. That's where the bodhisattvas are. And lastly is the land of eternal still light. That's where Buddha is. Amitabha is extremely compassionate, so he set up his pure land that all four worlds, they are all connected to each other. The moment that we chant Amitabha Buddha's name, we immediately dwell in eternal still light. This land has no form because that's the land of Buddha's Dharmakaya, his real essence. When we chant, the key is our inner stillness. Focus on the name. We're not thinking, have no afflictions. We're not having a chaotic mind. We're connecting to our inner peace, to our pure mind. Number four is corruption of being. Because of our corruption of views and corruption of afflictions, we have this body and mind that is coarse and debased. But by reciting Amitabha Buddha's name, we transform the corruption of beings into lotus flowers. There are four kinds of birth in this world, which is womb, egg, moisture, and transformation. Womb, like us human, we're out of mother's womb. Egg, like chicken. Moisture, like mosquitoes. And transformation, all the heavenly beings are transformation body. When we go to the Western Pure Land, we'll be metamorphosis of lotus flower. Lotus flower symbolizes purity. It's growing out of the mud, but it's not contaminated by the mud. It's still pure and beautiful. When we recite Amitabha Buddha's name, we already have a lotus flower growing in the Western Pure Land. The cause and the effect is simultaneous. In the Song Dynasty, there was a lady of Yue. She devoted her whole life chanting Amitabha Buddha's name, and she led all her servants into chanting. One of her servants was slacking up, so she scolded her. The servant became extremely diligent. After a while, the servant passed away and went to the Pure Land. She came back into another servant's dream to thank the lady for teaching her Pure Land Buddhism. The lady said, "I will only believe it if she comes into my dream." The next night, she dreamt of the servant. Then the lady asked her, "If you're in the Pure Land, can you take me there?" And the servant said, "Sure." So she brought her to the Western Pure Land, and most amazingly, she saw the lotus flower. They all have names of the practitioners that were alive at the time. So she was amazed to see their flowers there. Finally, she saw her own lotus flower. This is a big, beautiful, bright lotus flower with diamond pedestal. She was extremely happy, and then she woke up from her dream. In that same year, on her 80th birthday, she passed away standing up, holding an incense in her hands. So we all have a lotus flower when we are chanting the Amitabha Buddha's name. So have faith in this transformation. Number five is corruption of life. Our life is very short. We don't even live up to 100 for most of us. But if we recite Amitabha Buddha's name, we transform the corruption of life into infinite life. That's another name for Amitabha Buddha. His name is infinite life. And when we chant his name, we also become infinite life. life. And number 13 of his 48 vows, it says, provided I become a Buddha, if the measure of my life is limited, even by counting 100,000 Nyingma kotis of kalpas, then may I not attain enlightenment. So if my life is limited, even up to 100,000 Nyingma, which is a long, 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 long time, then I will not become enlightened. So Buddha's light is infinite, and when we chant his name, we become infinite light. What's so good about infinite light? Right now, we cannot cultivate into Buddhahood because our life is too short. By the time we finish eating, sleeping, playing, working, there's not much time to cultivate. But if we have infinite light, then we'll definitely have time to cultivate into Buddhahood. So in summary, if we don't chant Amitabha Buddha's name, then we will sure be imprisoned by our time, enmeshed in our misguided views, be ensnared by afflictions, rest complacently in our degradation and weakness of body and mind, and will be swallowed up by impermanence without life flashing by too quickly for us to cope. So this is called suffering and the cause of suffering. The side chanting Amitabha is the cessation of suffering and the path to end suffering. So this is the realization of the Four Noble Truths. In conclusion, why does chanting Amitabha Buddha's name work so well? It's because wondrous cause and wondrous effect are not apart from the one mind. The wondrous cause of reciting Amitabha Buddha's name and the wondrous effect of the purity and the pure land is not apart from our one mind. These are inherent features of our mind, and they are the creation of our mind. We have to know this, and then we will know that chanting will transform our life right now. It will bring us to the Western Pure Land after we pass away. This is a time of turmoil, but it's also a time for spiritual awakening. So rely on Amitabha Buddha and chant his name single-mindedly. That's the class for today. Thank you for listening. Amitabha.